Consider a problem where a coach is trying to choose the starting lineup for a basketball team. There are seven players, and the players' abilities in ball handling, shooting, rebounding, and defense are rated from 1 to 3, 1 being poor and 3 excellent. Also, each player can only play in certain positions. So, for example, player 1 can only play guard, player 2 can only play center, player 3 can play either a guard or a forward, and so on. And of course, a basketball lineup consists of 5 players, and then there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 other conditions given here that we need to satisfy. So now, given all these constraints, the coach wants to maximize the total shooting ability of the starting team. And we want to formulate this problem as an integer program and solve it in MPL. So the shooting ability is given in this column right here. And this is a typical situation where we need to select a set of options among the available alternatives subject to certain requirements that they need to satisfy. And in situations like this, it is natural to define the decision variables that correspond to the available alternatives. So we have 7 players, we could denote the corresponding binary variables indicating whether the player will start as x1 through x7, and then we can formulate the objective as maximizing the summation of shooting ability of each player multiplied by the corresponding decision variable. So we have 3 times x1, then plus 2 times x2, plus 3 times x3, plus 2 times x4, plus 3 times x5, then 1 x6, and finally 2 x7. So this is going to be the total shooting ability, and then we need to satisfy all the constraints we have here. And the first constraint is in fact listed here. The fact that we can start only 5 players needs to be expressed as a constraint. So we have x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus x5 plus x6 plus x7 equals 5. This is our first constraint. Next, constraints in part A. At least 3 members must be able to play guard, at least 2 members must be able to play forward, and at least 1 member must be able to play center. So we need to look at the positions that the players can play, and we need to ensure that each of these conditions is satisfied, right? At least 3 members must be able to play guard. So let's see which players can play guard. So player 1, which is x1, then player 3, which is x3, players 5 and 7. So there are 4 players who can play guard, right? And at least 3 of them must start. So we need to make sure that this sum is greater than or equal to 3. Then next, at least 2 members must be able to play forward. The players that can play forward are player 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So 3 through 7, they all can play forward. So we have x3 plus x4 plus x5 plus x6 plus x7 is greater than or equal to 2. Then we need to have at least 1 center. So there are 3 players who can play center. Player 2, 4, and 6. So x2 plus x4 plus x6 is greater than or equal to 1. Alright, so we are done with part A. Next, part B. The average ball handling, defensive, and rebounding level of the starting lineup must be at least 2. So we need to sum up the ball handling levels of all the players, divide by 5, and make sure that that average is greater than or equal to 2, right? And we need to do the same with defensive and rebounding levels as well. So for ball handling, we have these coefficients right here. So we'll have 3 times x1 plus 2 times x2 plus 2 x3 plus x4 plus 3x5, 3x6, and 3x7, and this must be greater or equal to 10, right? Because we would need to divide this by 5 and make it greater or equal to 2, right? So which is the same as just this here, greater or equal to 10. And then we do these similar constraints for rebounding and defensive ability as well. So for rebounding we have x1 plus 3x2 plus 2x3 plus 3x4 plus 3x5, 2x6, and 2x7 is greater or equal to 10. And for defensive ability we have 3x1 plus 2x2 plus 2x3 plus x4 plus 3x5 plus 3x6 plus x7 greater or equal to 10. All right, part B is done. So next, in part C, we have the condition that if player 3 starts, then player 5 cannot start. So if x3 is equal to 1, then x5 must be equal to 0. So we can express this as x5 is less than or equal to 1 minus x3, right? So whenever x3 is 1, this will imply that x5 must be equal to 0. And then whenever x3 is 0, which means that player 3 doesn't start, then x5 is either 0 or 1, so the player 5 can either start or not start, it doesn't matter, right? So this constraint is equivalent to saying that x3 plus x5 is less than or equal to 1. Alright, so part C is done. Then part D says that if player 1 starts, then players 4 and 5 must both start. So whenever x1 is equal to 1, then both x4 and x5 are equal to 1. So we could express this as x4 is greater than or equal to x1, and then x5 is greater than or equal to x1, which is the same as minus x1 plus x4 is greater than or equal to 0. And then minus x1 plus x5 is greater than or equal to 0. And actually, because the variables are binary, when they're binary, you could equivalently write these two constraints as a single constraint saying that x4 plus x5 is greater than or equal to 2 times x1. But this generally gives a weaker LP relaxation, even though it simplifies the model a little. So let's just keep these constraints as they are. So part D is done, and now the only part remaining is part E. Either player 6 or player 7 must start. So it means that x6 plus x7 must be greater than or equal to 1, right? So this will ensure that at least one of these two players starts. So we have x6 plus x7 is greater than or equal to 1. And of course, all variables x1 through x7 are binary. And this completes the model. So next we are going to feed this model into AMPL, and we will use the standard binary integer program code that we have. We will just prepare the data file for this particular model. So here is our general binary integer program model, and we have the parameters for the number of variables given by n. Then we have the parameter for number of equality constraints given by ME, number of greater than or equal to inequality constraints given by MG, and then the number of less than or equal to inequality constraints given by ML. So let's specify each of these parameters first. So we start with the parameter for the number of variables, and the number of variables that we have is 7. Then the next parameter would be for the number of equality constraints. We only have one equality constraint here given by this constraint right here. So ME is 1. Then the number of greater than or equal to inequality constraints, MG, is, let's count them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right, so we have 9 of this. And then the parameter for the number of less than or equal to inequality constraints is ML. We only have 1 right here. All right. So next we need to specify the parameter for the cost coefficient in the objective. So this model is written for the problem of maximizing the summation of CJ's XJ's subject to the constraints that we'll discuss later. So, but for now, let's focus on this parameter C. So we'll have C. So we have C1 is 3, then C2 is 2, and then the other coefficients would be 3, 2, 3, 1, and 2. So then we have BE is the vector of right-hand sides for the equality constraints. We have only one equality constraint, and the right-hand side for our equality constraint is 5. So we are done with the parameter BE. Next, BG would be the vector of right-hand sides for the greater than or equal to inequality constraints. So we said that we have 9 greater than or equal to inequality constraints. So we'll have 9 rows in this vector. And the right-hand sides for the greater than or equal to equality constraints are 3, 2, 1. Then we have 10, 10, 10. And 0, 0, 1. We skipped less than or equal to inequality constraints, which we'll specify later, right? Then for the next parameter, we have BL, the right-hand side for the less than or equal to constraint. We have only 1, and the right-hand side here is 1. All right, so next, we need to specify the left-hand sides. AE would be the left-hand sides for the equality constraints. We see here the equality constraints are given by the summation of AE's IJ's multiplied by XJ's. So we need to specify a vector for the single equality constraint that we have. This vector is the vector of all ones, right? So parameter AE is gonna be, first of all, we have 7 columns, right? And then we only have 1 row. So row 1 will consist of 7 ones. We are done with AE. Now the big one, the left-hand sides for greater than or equal to constraints. So again, we have 7 columns. And then we'll have 9 rows. And we need to specify the left-hand sides for all the greater than or equal to constraints now. Let's start with the first one. We have the coefficients of 1 for x1, x3, x5, and x7. The rest are zeros, right? So for x1 we have 1, for x2 0, for x3 1, for x4 0, x5 1, x6 0, x7 1. So the first constraint is done. Then for the second one, the variables x3 through x7 have the coefficient of 1, but then x1 and x2 have the coefficients of 0. So these are the left-hand side coefficients for the second constraint. Then we have x2 plus x4 plus x6, which corresponds to 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. All right, so for the fourth constraint, we have 3, 2, 2, 1, 3, 3, 3. Then the fifth constraint, we have the coefficients of 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 2, 2. And then the sixth constraint, the coefficients are 3, 2, 2, 1, 3, 3, 1. Next, this constraint right here is the greater or equal to constraint number 7, minus x1. And then coefficients for x2 and x3 are zeros, for x4 is 1, 5, 6, 7, zeros. Then the next constraint, negative x1 plus x5. So we have minus 1, then 3 zeros, 1 and 0, 0. And the last greater or equal to constraint is x6 plus x7 is greater or equal to 1. So we have the first five coefficients are zeros, and then we have 1 and 1. And we are done with the big matrix for greater or equal to constraints. And then finally we have AL. These are the less than or equal to constraints. And we have again seven columns, right? But only one row, because we only have one less than or equal to constraint. So we have 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, right? All right, so now I think we specified all the coefficients and we are ready to run the model. So let's check the .run file. So first let's save the data file. So in the run file, we need to make sure that we specify the right data file, lineup.dot. And then we are ready to open the terminal. So first I need to change the directory to my working folder. And now we can run ampl. So we have general bip.run. And here we get the solution. So we have the first, second, fourth, fifth, and seventh player start. So the ones that start off a bench would be the player 3 and player 6. All right, so and the objective is equal to 12. So for players 3 and 6, we have the answer no. And the rest are yes. With the objective of 12.